Okay. You gonna play your song, Jina?
Well, good morning, everyone. Happy Sabbath. We're going to get started on our worship this morning, and we're going to sing our song, our entry song, "The Lord is in His Holy Temple." Yes, we are here to worship the Lord, and His goodness is to us this morning. The Lord is in His holy temple, and all the earth keeps silent.
beautiful, dry summer. It's nice and cool every day. It doesn't interfere with rain or anything. Just another work day for me. And so, in a way, I shouldn't be sarcastic, but that's the fact of it. It is a beautiful day. And so long as the well keeps pumping water, the thorns growing, it is a beautiful day. And let's see, now next Saturday is camp meeting.
Yes.
And so
it will be closed.
And the church will be closed. Anything else I need to
We need to highlight June 24.
June 24.
We need to read that little section there.
Okay.
The other side.
June 24. And so our son went to Cuba and he had quite an experience. And so it was like back years in the past, no gas, no Bibles.
Of course, a two-wheel cart to get you around.
You don't talk about God. This one guy, baptized somebody at Wisconsin camp. The missionary we went to see baptized someone at Wisconsin last year. And Merlin says they have a building 11 stories high. And there's lots of people working there. And they are monitoring the internet. And if they find that you promoting, baptizing, and when he went back, what happened, Rick?
He ended up in jail.
Wisconsin advertised him at their camp meeting. They put a picture of him on their flyer, and Cuba found it.
So Cuba, the people in that 16-story building, found him on the internet, and he went back, he ended up in prison.
And what happened to his home?
He lost everything. They took everything.
They took everything.
Tragedy. So he's going to die, and he heard that this group is praying. And so somehow he got a hold of this guy, and he says, pray for me.
Says, well, I'll pray for you, but I need paper.
Yeah.
I need ink or something.
We need paper to print on so we can get Bible studies. Okay, you pray, we paper. So he actually went. Did Merlin go to the hospital?
I thought they brought Merlin in, yeah.
They put it in a hospital or whatever, but they have to make it look like they're stealing the stuff.
Yeah.
To get the paper, because you can't legally give that to them, because paper's like gold. You can't even get paper in the communist.
Can't get paper or ink.
So this
I can't just give it to you, because then I'll get in trouble. I gotta put it someplace, and you gotta figure out how to get it out of there so it makes it look like you're stealing.
They make ink out of used motor oil.
So this guy is known to be praying, and so Raul wants you pray for me. Well, yeah, I can. I don't make any promises, but I will pray for you. So I think Merlin and him, I don't know quite, I, Merlin says, I do know a drug that will shrink the prostate. It is some big long name. And so Merlin's going to get him. He's going to get him. So anyway, in the process, they got the paper, and they had to get a bunch of gurneys and a bunch of vans. Is this true? They got a bunch of vans to the hospital and shipped a bunch of people out with paper on the gurney.
Sneaked it out in ambulances on gurneys.
And that sounds like fiction, but that's what we heard. And he was there a week ago.
And Merlin could have told stories right just when he was down there. So this missionary, you just don't want to miss
it. So Raul is going to die unless he gets prayed for. And so that's what we have. So anyway, that's coming up here.
And he goes, "Would your God and answer this prayer?"
So the world is in confusion. Our lesson today is about confusion. Everywhere there's confusion. And so anyway, so we're going to have some music now, right, Gina?
Yeah, let's turn in your song sheets to number 127, Springs of Living Water. A good get up and go one.
Okay.
One sharp. 127. Pentecostal now, huh?
Pentecostal? No, this is Seventh-day Adventist.
Yeah, well, we've been accused of being Pentecostal.
Okay, this is Pentecostal, 607. Here we go. There's a day coming. When Babylon is done, we're told that Babylon is going to be done. There's a day coming. And that's what this is about. Okay, singing, 607. What a day that will be.
Talk about confusion. We've been accused of that.
There's a day coming when no heartache shall come, no clouds in the sky, nor tears in the eye. Oh, what a day that will be.
Thank you.
with what happened this morning. I almost forgot everything. You don't know what that's like. You probably think I'm here. Oh, there is one here. You forgot what happened this morning. Here, you know? Well, there's two of us that knows what that's like. But you know what? If you listen to the Holy Spirit and a thought comes to you, you have no trouble pronouncing it. Names, especially people's names. When somebody's name comes to my mind, it's sometimes something that's probably spiritual. I can remember. How about that? Jesus, looking in his face, he takes me by the hand and leads me to the promised land. Let's go on number two, Gina. There will be no sorrow there. See it.
Thank you.
evil, perversion. I don't care if it's sexual or entertainment or whatever it is. People are into evil. This says walking in sunlight. That's where I want to be. And I'm careful if I don't walk in darkness. 4, 8, 9. Walking in sunlight.
One flat, Jake.
4, 8, 9.
Thank you. I heard that organ going.
Yeah, we caught and picked and tore them, I guess.
Oh, hey, Linda's got to tell me an announcement.
Next Thursday, remember, there'll be no Bible study because of camp meeting. So we'll all be in Lincoln. Next Thursday, no Bible study.
If you can make it, it'd be great. Sean Boucher, the main speaker. He's one of the top Adventists worldwide speakers in the world. So he'd be awesome to listen to.
Dad, you're not done.
We're not through yet.
Offering.
You got.
Oh, offering?
What I should do here, Gina?
Offering.
Oh, offering? Is there something I'm supposed to say?
Oh, I